Good morning, YouTube. Today's video is going to be quite a bit different than our usual content. Today, we're not going to be playing with supercars. We're going to set up a backup generator for my house.
So are you recording all of the nefarious activities?
If you're new to the channel, my name is Dan, and this is my garage. And this channel is normally all about the supercar ownership experience. But today, like I said, we're going to be setting up a backup generator. So if you didn't know, we moved to our house that we have here. It's kind of out in the middle of nowhere, and we also live in Texas. So I don't know if you guys heard about it, but 2 years ago we had a really bad snowstorm, and I know most of you that live in northern climates are like, so what? Well, yeah, it basically totally f***ed Texas, and everyone lost power, and people actually died from it. It was a legit problem for Texas. The reason we're gonna set up this is because we're about to get another big winter storm, and I just don't trust that our government has done a good job and fixed the electrical issues that we had with the power grid. So I'm fully expecting to lose power on Thursday. It is Monday. So we have to do this fast, and it's gonna be tricky because some of the parts don't arrive until Wednesday. Here's a big disclaimer at the beginning of the video. Please go hire professionals to help you with this. Do not do DIY. I don't know why I'm doing DIY. I'm only doing DIY because it's last minute. I tried to get some professionals out here to do the wiring and stuff. Everyone's busy. Let me show you the generator and we'll talk all about the specifics of why I chose this generator and all sorts of whatever, blah, blah, blah. Okay, cool. Okay, I bought the Duramax XP13000E. It's a 13,000 watt generator. It has a AC capacity of 10,500 watts when it's running, a fuel tank capacity of 8.3 gallons. It's a 20 horsepower engine. So this is a gasoline only engine. And I think a lot of you are gonna say, well, why didn't you buy a dual fuel or a propane or a natural gas generator? And I would have loved to, except for my house does not have any sort of gas supply. We only have electricity, so that is a big problem. And I am not going to spend the money to install a propane tank just for a generator that we probably only use maybe once a year, most likely once every 2 or 3 years. So that's the thing. It's not meant to be a full house generator. I don't need that. I don't think that's gonna be a big deal. We live, yes, out in the middle of nowhere, but we're also still reasonably close to the city. So I wouldn't expect us to lose power for extended periods of time. And I did look into the full house backups and all that stuff, and we're talking like over $10,000 to get something like that set up versus this generator shipped to my door by Amazon was $800. And all the hardware to set it up only cost a few hundred more dollars. So all in, we're talking like under $1,200. And yeah, it's not gonna be able to power everything in the house, but we'll show you what it can power, and that's the whole point, is we want to at least be able to have some lights, be able to cook food, and be able to at least run the pool pump. And that is my big fear, is not having the pool pump running, because that can be very expensive, and homeowners insurance does not cover pools when they freeze. Let's unbox this guy. Okay, there's the generator and all the stuff that came with it, which isn't a whole lot. Okay, so looking at the instructions, first thing we got to do is connect the negative battery terminal, which is right, there's the cable, there's the battery, it just screws on, so that's pretty easy. Okay, so the next step is that orange or red bracket right there needs to be removed. I guess it's for shipping. There's one on each side, so we'll get those removed. All right, so you can see if you flip it up on its side, it's much easier to get to that bracket. Just a couple bolts here and there. So next up, we install these little feet and the wheels so that we can actually move it around. And finally, we install the two handles. Now we gotta tip it upright and then add oil. All right, I actually have to go get oil because I don't have any 10W30. I have like all the stuff for Ferraris and 5W40 and 60 weight and crazy shit. So, all right, I gotta get some 10W30. It takes 1.2 liters. And then we also need to actually go get some gas and get this thing filled up. So I'll probably wait until I get a gas can to do that. So another thing of note is there is a gas station close to my house that sells non-ethanol gasoline. I'm gonna use that exclusively in this thing because it's probably gonna be sitting around a lot. So I'm worried that, like, you know, the old gas will get nasty. We'll also put some stabilizer stuff in it just to keep it good. All right, it's been a few days and I have all the parts. It is now Wednesday. Tomorrow is when it's supposed to get cold, so we gotta get this installed today. So let me show you what we got and then let's have at it. Okay, so the first thing we had to do is we got a 50 amp breaker, and this is one that will fit in my box. We also have a connection box. We have the power cord. We have a generator lockout, and this is gonna be a really important piece, and we'll install that and I'll show you what it does in just a minute. And then of course we have some 6-gauge wire. So we needed some really beefy wire, and that's because it's gonna be pulling 50 amps at 240 volts. So it is a pretty substantial connection. So let's get all the wiring done while we can, because we're gonna have to shut off the main breaker to the entire house. All right, here is the main for the house. All right, so here's what we have to do is we need to use a generator interlockout. So what this device does is it will go right here and basically block this fuse from being on when this top fuse is being on. So we're gonna have to move the water heater somewhere else, and then we will put the generator fuse here and then wire it up. So obviously we have to turn off the main to do this, so we gotta get this panel off, and obviously you should hire a certified electrician to do any of this. Okay, so we've got the box mounted, we've got the plug taken out, it's got the conduit running, and we've got the box open. Obviously the main is off, and we opened up that breaker space. So now what we'll do is we'll put in the breaker, we'll wire it up, and then we have to cut the slot for that little interlock kit. So we get all that done and then run the wires through the conduit and into the generator plug. Okay, so the basic concept is the red, black, and white are going into the plug. Obviously the green is our ground, it goes to the chassis. And then in the box, we have the black and red going to the breaker, we have the white going to the white terminal, and the green going to the green terminal. So it's basically like wiring up any breaker, 240 breaker. So now we just gotta put on the interlock and put that back together and then test it. Okay, so here is the breaker guard. I actually had to cut this a bit because it was, well, it's just too big. So when you turn on the generator, this will be the generator switch. I gotta change the label. So when you turn on the generator, you push this up and turn on the switch. Now you can see this blocks the main. You cannot turn on the main anymore. So to turn on the main, you turn that on, and then when this goes over, see, now I can't lift it up. I can't turn on the generator. There you go. Okay, YouTube, we're down to the final steps. We just gotta get the generator to run. So we gotta add, I think it's 1.8 liters of oil, and we gotta add gas. I went and filled up a portable gas tank, so we're gonna get some gas in there. I'm also using no ethanol gas, so I don't have to worry about it going bad in a short period of time. If you can't get a hold of no ethanol gas, I would use some stabilizer into the fuel, because chances are the generator's gonna be sitting around most of the time. Another thing you could do is just drain it. What we'll do is once we start it, I'm actually not going to run the house on it today because I've had the electricity off for about 2 hours now, and I want to heat the house back up before it gets cold tomorrow and make sure everything's stable. So we've got the power connect, and I'll show you how that works once we get this all set up. So I bought this 14-gallon gasoline thing so I can siphon gas into the tank. So this is 8.3 gallons, so basically it'll take up more than half of that. And so I'll probably actually go fill that up again today before it gets cold tomorrow, just so it's full. I just put in the oil, so I overfilled it and had to drain it out, but just be careful of that. Okay, we got gas in the generator. So we're gonna kind of simulate what we would do if we were actually going to be connecting it to the house. So I'm not gonna flip the breakers, but we will fire it up, and then I'm gonna turn it off just so you can hear me better. First thing we do is actually get the generator started. Then theoretically you flip the transfer switches, plug it in there, plug it in here, then hit the breaker here, and then you should have power. So let's at least start this thing up and see how this goes. So first thing is we gotta turn on the fuel. Where is it? There it is, fuel. All right, it has fuel. Then you make sure the breakers are off. They are. Turn on the battery and push start. That was crazy. Volts, that's pretty good.
All right, so idle control knows when it's being used and when it's not, so it'll actually make it idle. So obviously you don't want to do that when you're actually running it on the house. Seems to work pretty good. It's not that quiet, but you know what? Hey, it's better than having no power.
Okay, so that works. All right, now we can kind of go through and actually simulate this. So again, we'd assume that the power is already off. So, all right, we'd come into the master. We'd flip this up and turn the main off and then turn the generator breaker on. And at the same time, we'd probably flip off almost everything. Like, we'd probably leave on a few things like, I don't know, like pool stuff. That's one of my biggest concerns. We don't have enough energy to run the furnace and air conditioner, so we can't do that. Probably turn off the cooktop. Might even leave on the septic just so it doesn't freeze. This is now the water heater. I gotta label it. Obviously we'd turn off the RV, and then the sub feed we'd turn on, but we'd go turn off a bunch of the fuses. So this is what runs like a lot of the lights in the house and plugs and stuff. So we would want that. So anyway, just imagine that we turn this off, turn this on, flip that up. Then we plug this guy in here, which we can do because the breaker's off. There. Okay, plug that in, and then we plug it in there. So then theoretically this would be running, and we'd plug this in. By the way, these cables are like super stiff, so like trying to get them to go where you want them is pretty difficult. I actually need two hands. Okay, so it'd be plugged in here, this would be running, and then we'd hit the circuit breaker to on, and then theoretically it would be feeding the house at that point. And then we'd do the reverse when we're all done, flip that off, turn this off, unplug this. Come on. Good lord, these things are tight. There. Unplug that. Close that, and then flip the breakers, and we'd be all set. All right, YouTube, there you go. So it's pretty easy to do the wiring. It was actually easier than I thought it would be. But at the same time, if you don't feel comfortable doing it, please hire an electrician. Don't do it if you don't know what you're doing or if you don't feel comfortable doing it. Just don't. It's not worth killing yourself. It's not worth blowing up your house or catching on fire. So now I have a generator. It obviously can't power the whole house, but it can at least power certain things. What I also bought were some small space heaters. So at least if it's really cold, we can kind of like huddle up in a bedroom and just heat up one bedroom. My biggest thing is, again, I want to make sure that the pool pump can run, because if that pool pump stops, it'll freeze and crack, and then homeowners insurance does not cover that, and that's like super expensive. So buying a generator and wiring up is substantially cheaper than having to fix one pool pump. Well worth the money in my opinion. We have the generator, now we're gonna have it for years to come, and hopefully we don't need it very often. But that's gonna do it for this video. Please like, share, and subscribe, and we'll be back to playing with some cars and doing car stuff, so you're gonna wanna stay tuned. It's gonna be sweet.